Hi everyone, my name is Jessica and I am the booktuber behind Peace Love Books XO.
Hi, I'm Jessen from Jessen Reads Romance.
Hey everyone, I'm Jenny.
Hi, I'm Melissa.
And I'm Lacey.
And we're here for a sneak peek of Bridgerton Season 2. So the Bridgerton fandom is like hardcore diehard fans.
And I think that brings a lot of controversy and just conversation in general.
Netflix, you better do a good job with season 2 of Bridgerton.
Please don't mess this up.
Oh, we have the queen.
Your presence is noted.
Oh my God, her hair. Always a classic look.
Allow it to now be my honor.
Oh, the queen's gonna select her in front of everyone.
The season's diamond.
Who was it, Edwina?
Miss Edwina Sharma.
Yes.
She's so pretty. She's so beautiful. Mm.
Yes. Okay, so we knew she was going to be the diamond of the season, so I'm excited that they actually introduced her that way, because the queen is not in the books, and she does not introduce any diamond of the season, so that's super exciting.
You look at her the way I look at a finished painting, brother.
Every man needs a muse, does he not?
Anthony. I was watching this recently with someone and they were like, he's not gonna get anyone with those mutton chops.
I remember they were pretty big in the first season. I was not a fan of them, so I'm glad they're not there anymore.
Agreed.
I only hope I shall be afforded the pleasure of a dance.
I'm excited to see Anthony dance in this season. He didn't dance at all in season 1, if I remember correctly, so I'm really excited to see him finally get on the dance floor and have to interact with people for the first time.
Forgive my directness. Do you have any thoughts about children?
Other than the fact that I desire them so.
Nothing like a first date, do you want children? Question.
Bro, chill out. Like, this is your first dance.
Do you play any musical instruments?
He barely knows what he wants. Like, okay, Anthony, sure. You were just in love with that girl last season.
Is your father in attendance? I should like to speak with him.
Her father is not in attendance.
Sadly, my father died years ago.
Oh.
She doesn't have a dad.
I'm so sorry.
Something to relate to each other.
As did mine.
Yeah, Anthony's father being dead is a huge part of the second book.
I hope they explore that more in the show.
Perhaps you could speak with my sister.
I really want to see Kate's reaction though right now.
Because she's going to be so pissed.
Here she is now, Kate.
Ah, Lord Bridgerton. I see you've met Miss Edwina.
Look at that eyebrow.
Her sister.
Miss Sharma, my lord.
Perfect. She's already super icy and like angry towards him.
Would you join me in the retiring room, sister?
You can feel how much they're not big fans of each other.
You are not to go near that man, do you understand?
She is who I shall marry.
Yes, sweeping declarations from Anthony.
There are a few things I must make you aware of.
I love it already.
You can tell she just detests him on screen. She does not like him.
It is A+, and I feel like it sets us up for really good sexual tension for the rest of the show.
I'm about to watch the Pall Mall scene, which is probably the most iconic part of this entire book.
This is a scene that is so pivotal to Kate and Anthony's romance.
Let us toss a coin.
Last year, we promised to let the youngest pick first.
We pick based on alphabetical order.
Sorry. I am ready for Pall Mall.
Please, take your pick, Miss Edwina.
He's already flirting with her.
An excellent choice.
Yep, she gets blue. Mallet of Death, pick it. Black, yes, okay.
The mallet of death.
The mallet of death.
Is this yours?
No, no.
It's Anthony's mallet.
You near threatened to beat me the last time I touched that.
You exaggerate.
He's laying on it thick.
I know some men cannot perform without their familiar tools.
I love it.
Innuendos.
Like a child with a blanket.
This banter is sensational.
Mm. I can play perfectly well with any mallet. I wish you the best of luck.
Are we to stand around deliberating all day, or shall we play?
They get so competitive. Okay, the pink one's left. Okay, there is pink. There is pink. He gets pink. I love it.
They are off to a slow start, but I have hopes of bloodshed.
Lady Dansbury is just hilarious. I love her. Lady Danbury, I think, was in like one or two scenes in the book, and so I love the fact that she's meddlesome again and trying to make things happen.
Our matchmaking efforts last season were quite wise. Indeed, Lady Bridgerton.
I love these two conniving, and I loved it in the first season. It's also funny because it's not actually part of the books.
Oh, dash.
Oh, is this what I've been waiting for? Ah, like, Kate and Anthony have to go fetch their balls together.
One of the greatest things about romance is the forced proximity trope, when the characters are forced to be near each other, especially whenever they don't like each other. So this is perfect.
I just want everyone to note that they don't have a chaperone here.
There's nothing for it then.
She's going in. Oh, I love her shoes.
Ladies, do not step in mud. I love that Kate's doing that. Oh, she just dropped her dress.
Yes, go Kate.
Is he impressed?
Your play, my lord.
I'm just really excited because Kate gets under Anthony's skin in a way that he really hasn't been vulnerable in so many years. And I really love that for him.
That little smirk he just gave her.
Not afraid to get dirty. I love Kate so much.
Help.
Of course she's stuck. he's gonna pull her, and then in a true K-drama fashion,
they're gonna like topple all over each other.
Oh. Okay, they both fall on nice.
Yes, that's what I wanted.
It is not amusing.
I did not say it was.
I love it because Anthony takes himself so seriously, and this is fun, and she's having fun. Look, oh, the smile, perfect.
This is like a turning point for them.
I believe I underestimated you, Michelle.
That seems to be the theme of our acquaintance.
That would have been the perfect time for an almost kiss, but it's okay.
I shall never surrender to you on the sporting field.
Kate's a beast. She's my hero.
Interesting.
Is something the matter?
I feel like that bench has some significance. Perhaps to Anthony's father.
Lord Bridgerton, do you not wish to retrieve
the game is over.
Anthony and feelings don't mix. He's gonna have a negative reaction if he starts getting deep in his feels when Kate's around.
I feel like it progressed from like competitiveness to like, I hate her, but like, I think that maybe I love her to like this very tender moment where obviously like this brings memories of his father.
I have a soft spot in my heart for Anthony because of what happened with his father and how much that affected him. We better see Newton, that's all I can say. Newton is the corgi and he is a character in himself in the books.
We love Newton.
Again, the costumes are just amazing. It's Newton! Oh my gosh, he's so cute.
I have to wonder if you might not secretly rejoice with the Viscount to break the engagement.
Why would you ever say such a thing?
I love how Lady Danbury just has her hand in everything.
They are betrothed.
They're betrothed?
The Viscount made a charming proposal.
That did not happen in the book. So they are actually planning on marrying each other, and that's gonna add another layer of conflict.
In the book, they don't even get that far. They maybe get like two conversations in and that's it. And I really hope like Kate and Edwina just have such a strong like bond. I really hope that that doesn't get in between them at all.
Lady Danbury.
Mr. Dorset.
Who's this?
Who are you?
What a pleasure to see you here today. Miss Sharma, perhaps you would be so kind as to accompany me on a turn around the lake.
Oh, is he gonna try to court Kate? And then is Anthony gonna get jealous? He's looking.
Oh, Anthony is not happy about
Very
him.
Very well, my lord. A turn would be most pleasant.
Thank goodness, I love that Anthony's gonna get jealous because Kate has a suitor. This is very different from the books.
The brooding stare again. I'm gonna say that like 20 times, he's so angry.
I love all this slow-mo realization that Kate is the one that he actually wants.
I see you are smiling, Vivi. See the amusements London has to offer?
I'm just like waiting for Newton to pop up.
That knot will never hold. It is perfectly adequate.
Excuse me.
Of course, Anthony needs to show off in front of Kate.
Oh, look, Newton.
Pardon me. Michonne.
Lord Bridgerton.
Oh, the eye contact. Chef's kiss. Amazing.
He's feeling something right now.
Some hand holding. Ah. Oh my gosh.
Oh, both of them went in. Oh my gosh. Oh. Oh. Poor Newton. I'm like flashbacks to Pride and Prejudice right now. He's soaked. Okay.
Refreshing indeed.
Oh, Edwina. Kate's gonna not want to react, but she's going to react.
Come now, it is not proper to stare.
Kate, take your own advice.
I love it. That little up and down look. Kate, she's running from her feelings right now, and I love it. This just makes me like 10 times more excited to see the entire show because there are so many gaps of things I don't even know that were not in the book, like who this guy is that's apparently trying to court Kate. And I think it's only fair. It's fair play that Kate gets to make Anthony jealous.
I am so excited, and I definitely think that just these clips are bringing in some like A-plus sexual tension that we're gonna need to see much more of.
If you love stories where the characters are really close to each other, they love each other, but also get into a lot of shenanigans, you should definitely watch Bridgerton.
Yes, I already took the day off of work and I'm gonna watch the entire thing the day it comes out. I'm so excited.
Bridgerton season 2 is now streaming on Netflix.
It doesn't get any better than this.